Right, Martin Lewis takes your calls on the latest energy price increases, and do parents have a duty to tell their overweight children that they are fat? Should the F word be out of bounds? Katie Hopkins thinks that if your child is fat, you should tell them. She's here in a moment.
Competition time first this week. We've just a thing to keep you bang on trend with the latest gadgets, designer goods and £10,000 in cash.
Earlier today, our top man of technology, Steve Wilson, broke into our competition prize lockup to dig out digital dividends.
There really is a shed load of stuff here.
And for this week only, it's your chance to win the lot.
You could bag this Victoria Beckham Liberty, along with a Rolex watch, this family of Apple gadgets, a Canon DSLR camera, a GoPro Hero 3, a games console, tiddlywinks, two hybrid bikes, two pairs of Ray-Bans, two Bang & Olufsen phones, a Nike fuel band, a Chanel makeup bag with products, and much, much more. We've also uncovered an incredible £10,000 in tax-free cash, which we'll ensure goes in your bank account, as cash never goes in the trash. So, for your chance to win this huge prize package, just answer this question correctly. What is the first name of the famous fashion designer daughter of Sir Paul McCartney? A. Lola. B. Kyla. C. Stella. Call 09041 61 99 99. Calls cost no more than £1.54 from BT Landlines. Calls from other networks may be higher and from mobiles will be considerably more. Text A, B or C as your answer to 63335. Texts cost £1.50 plus one standard network rate message. You can also enter for free at the website. Entrance must be 18 or over. Entries made after lines close at 5 p.m. on Sunday the 20th of October will not be counted but may still be charged. Best of luck.
Yes, good luck with that. Now, should you ever tell a child they're fat? It's a common dilemma faced by many parents. In an exclusive this morning survey by One Poll, 70% of those polled believe it is the parents' job to tell their child they're overweight.
Well, last week, a leading obesity expert provoked a backlash after suggesting parents have a duty to be honest with overweight children.
Katie Hopkins agrees. In fact, she goes as far as to say, behind every fat child, there's often a fat mother who should take full responsibility. But Sonia Poulton thinks otherwise. She believes Katie Hopkins or any other parent would tell a child their fat is no better than a playground bully. Welcome to both of you. So, Katie, let's start with you first of all. I mean, you believe that if you don't do it, someone else will.
Absolutely. You know, for me, I think every fat child lives in the shadow of a fat parent. And I think, you know, parents that say, oh, we have to protect their feelings, we have to look after them, we have to, you know, soften the blow. Playground bullies are not as kind. And I've done trips to swimming pools where children come out, the fat children come out crying because they've been bullied by others, bullied by their peers. So I think it's really important parents get a grip, tell their children they're fat and get together, sit down and do something about it.
So, whose fault is it that those children are fat?
It's absolutely the parents' fault that those children are fat. I think they need to look in the mirror, look at themselves and recognise it's their fault.
So if it's their fault, and this is something we mentioned in the news review earlier on, why would you tell your children they're fat? It's your fault, you've done it, you're the parent, you fed them rubbish, whatever you've done, and there are many people on limited budgets whose children eat healthy food. It's possible to do.
Yeah.
If it's your fault as a parent, then why not only have a child that has the likelihood of health problems in the future, but also you'll give them psychological problems as well?
Oh, for goodness sake, we've got 1 in 10 children going into school at age of 4 obese already. So if you're not going to sit down with your child and say, look, we've created a problem here, you're fat, I've made this problem, we need to sort it out. You know, these days all we want to do in society, isn't it, is put people in cotton wool. You know, the National Child Measurement Programme says, no, we can't use the word obese anymore, it might frighten people. Now we need to use the word overweight. We need to change this attitude and really, you know, recognise that people have created a problem and we need to sort it out, because the NHS currently are copping at the cost of sorting this problem
out. Well, it's interesting, because I just tweeted a lady actually who said that your children are weighed at school, and I said, yeah, we'll be talking about that, because as part of this National Child Measurement Programme, which you just mentioned, all children across the country are weighed
at
the age of 5, that's what I'm going to say, and then again at 10. Unless their parents opt out, 6% can refuse to take part. The school nurses who take the measurements indicate it's often the heaviest children whose parents are opting out, but we're too politically correct to even gather robust data in order to fix the problem.
Stop this child hating. I mean, this is is ridiculous. We are now psychologically savvy as people. Okay, we're not operating like Neanderthals, dealing with people as if they have no emotions and no feelings. We now know that the old saying, sticks and stones may break my bones, names will never hurt me, is a crock. It's an absolute nonsense. The truth is that you do that to a child, they will be reliving the traumas of it on a psychiatrist's couch when they're in their 30s.
Sonia, is it not fair to say, though, that you're almost being cruel not to do something about it? Now, I think there's ways of
doing it. I'm not saying that, but I'm not saying don't do something about it.
Because it's the F word, isn't it? It's this kind of your fat.
It's what is your approach? My approach is to treat children with love and respect, not savage and attack them, OK? And this idea that Katie has been on swimming trips is one of those little stories that don't quite ring true again with Katie, because, honestly, Katie, if you're not going to be there for your child's birthday, you're not there for swimming trips, so get a grip. So we already know that that isn't the truth, OK? But what is the truth is that these children are being destroyed by the kind of playground bullies that Katie raises. And what we need to do is introduce more kindness into society. We need more education. Yeah, but we do, Philip. We need more education.
I take all of that on board, but being hugely PC and not using the word fat and being very careful about what we say is creating a nation of fat children.
We have more worries than just people being overweight. What about being underweight? Underweight is a problem as well. We talk about being underweight all the time.
Yes. We've got plus size school uniforms now on the high street. That
100
is wrong.
Years ago,
we are resizing
a fat child would have been a novelty and would have stopped people in the street.
It's a much bigger issue. I mean, what kind of person would blame the child for how they look? What kind of person?
How do you deal with it with the parents then? How do you can't? Yeah. I mean, obviously you're saying, well, you've got to be nice to them. We appreciate that. I don't want to see anyone.
I'm saying deal with people with some respect and some understanding. We are advanced
it's
now.
Working
we're much more
really
advanced
well
than
at the
we
moment,
were.
Isn't it, Sonia? This respect and understanding. It's working really well because we've really sorted out the problem, haven't we? We haven't got a problem at all with obesity, have we, Sonia?
It's only one of many problems.
It's not a major problem.
But it is, but there are ways to deal with it. And going up to a child and saying, you're fat.
You're not giving us any ways to deal with it, Sonia. You haven't given one example yet. You've just criticised and put down the ideas we have.
A perfect example is to introduce decent cooking into schools. I just told you, my daughter's doing cookery today. She's doing sausage and lentils. That's ridiculous. So what we need to do is introduce more healthy meals into the cooking agenda.
Mary Berry believes all children should be taught to cook 10 full meals at school. She was speaking at the Cheltenham Literary Festival and said it should be that every child, when they leave school, can do 10 meals, because when they leave home, they've got to be able to eat healthily.
Do you know what? I think they're doing a pretty good job at eating already, aren't they? I think they could do a little better job of eating less and moving more, and that's the sort of advice I'd be giving to them. Get less in your face and get more on your feet and out on the street and running about. We've got to give the hard messages, and someone needs to man up and give those tough messages, because we're not doing it, Holly, at the moment.
Say it's your child and you're sitting there going, gosh, this is me and I have made mistakes, and my child, I maybe have fed them the wrong things, and my child is, this person we're talking about is overweight. Would not a more sensible way to approach it, instead of going, darling, you're fat, you need to go on a diet, would it not be better to kind of go, right, let's go and walk the dogs together, let's go and do this?
Of course it
would. Just ways of doing the same thing without... And I know that I sound like one of those people that won't say the word fat, but when I know I do...
Holly, you do sound one of those wet, woolly...
Holly, what's wrong with that?
It's one of those wet, woolly attitudes, Holly, that I really don't like.
I would never compromise my child's health. Ever.
Yes, but you're,
I would,
Holly,
after, I
you're not a mother.
You will be compromising the child's mental health if you start labelling them the way that Katie would. Look, Katie, seriously, you really need to look at yourself.
I'm looking.
No, darling, do not look at me and expect to get a reflection of yourself. That's not going to happen.
When you've got a zebra in a wig shouting at
be
you,
quiet.
Really, it's too
I've not got a wig. This is my real hair. Don't be ridiculous.
She's got to stop. No, stop talking at once.
She does it every time.
One at a time. Your turn.
Thank you, Philip. The truth is that we do not need an ugly society where people are savaging and attacking each other. I'd like to know what happened to you as a child, because something bad happened.
Now stop.
Because otherwise you would not be this ugly.
Now stop. Your turn.
I believe that we're far too soft, and Holly's a good example of a soft kind of parent that needs to really recognise there are children that are fat. We need to tell those children they are fat in order that we can start doing something about it, because taxpayers are frankly sick of paying for 1,000 children that were admitted to hospital last year because they have type 2 diabetes, because they can't breathe at night in their beds because their own body weight is crushing them. And that's the problem we've got. So all of this nicety, all this being kind, teaching them to cook nice meals, that's not the answer. The answer is you are fat. You, as a parent, you are fat. Get a grip, do something about it. And if we have a society where we're allowing people to opt out of a measurement programme, really, what sort of society are we becoming, really?
Final words, Sonia.
When are we going to start measuring the contents of people's characters rather than what they look like physically? That is the problem with this society. It's so shallow.
But it's
I'm talking about an overall health. Everything is costing us a fortune. People smoking, people drinking, people being horrible bigots are creating problems because they're the stem of hate crime. So lots of people are costing us fortunes. Let's stop targeting people for being overweight and let's look at everything holistically about the mental health of people, their emotional health, everything, rather than
nonsense.
I don't sit on here in order for a newspaper to pick up sound bites for me. I'm looking at the big term picture of helping people.
And the picture's pretty big.
Thank you. It's
bigger than your understanding.
Thank you. Right, there you go. We'd love to know what you've got to say about that.